Son of a bitch.
You said move on to some...
TGM up through the river, but the damage has already been done to Loda. Sing Sing being isolated out here. Loda, there's the instant slow over down onto Bulba. With the lightning fall, there is a split out the Valble, but Bulba, he's going to go down the top lane. Actually, killed by the creep wave, so it doesn't give us our first blood. It just gives us a double kill. But also back with the last hit, that's going to be his full Vanguard done.
Nice.
And Shadow Fiend, it is a Yule set to build. Either that or a 4-star. Look at just run. Wave of Terror gets the reveal. Attack. In for the bolt. Koifa. Looking for one attack. Raise. There's a pickup. There's a throwdown. SF needs one more attack to kill him off. He will get the ulti out. Pycat. Okay, he'll also die. Skywrath may be able to finally get a little bit of a revenge kill here. While Bulba needs a little bit more mana. Needs a slow over on Arcade as well. And Arcade turns into the magic missile. Bulba. Very quick onto that spin. But now that Nikwa's arrived, he's only got face boost to get himself out. He's moving towards the Ancients. And Nikwa, how smart was that? He moved further to the left so he could take the aggro from the Ancients. So there was, yeah, I kind of... Well, I'm Pycat. Watching him last hit, he only got 3 out of the 4. Yeah. But right now, like, the damage output which I'm seeing him do, I've seen in the past. So I'm not feeling like the buff ups have really changed too much.
Quillspray's stack damage increased from 30 to 36 level 4.
Okay, that's not bad. Pycat, that's a lot of trouble. Abra Ball putting that blink dagger to work. Can they actually get a revenge kill here? Arcade's moving up for this one. He's not in range for the swap. I think he just tried to do the swap. And there it is. Pull him down. Now with the Stampede. The Magic Missile will be there. And G-Rex stole Magic Missile. That's really nice up against Nikwa. So Arcade will be able to survive this one. But Nikwa finds himself in a four-man sandwich. And he'll end up dying up on top of that high ground. So process. But they have no idea that he is up there. They would have just thought, you know, and he's TP'd out. He's asking for a gank, and there's more TP support coming up.
This could be so perfect for Team Tinker.
Oh, they've got a good initiation off. That's over on Pycat. Swap back, though, means they can't fall for the initiation. The stun over there for Bulldog, not to mention that lightning damage is really, really difficult. Finally, Regirax will come back in again, a little from Fade Bolt and an Urn Charge. That may... No, it's not enough to kill off EGM. He can actually still counter that Urn Charge as well. And with Nikru on the front lines, Koifa's ulti does a little bit of work, but Loda joins the engagement, pulling back on Koifa with that Vortex. Admiral Baldon jumping back in again. That stun from EGN keeps the fight alive with a 2-2 trade-off. They're looking back over to Bulba. Loda doesn't really have a lot of mana for this one. He tries to Sol Ring jump, but they have the Urn Charge with the Lightning. One more spray on the back, and Brilsback will take the kill. In fact, he just did it with a physical DPS. So they get the return of Admiral Bulldog.
Oh no,
blinks
Bulldog.
Up. He's looking for that Hoof Stomp, but he can't get in range of Nikwa. Now he is in range, and he'll get that stun off with a swap away from Arke. He's looking for the end kill with the double edge, but Nikwa down to 69 life points, but still alive. Arke needs a little bit more help, and EGM. Oh, that's a good time to blink by Bulldog. That is split Earth. VS, he'll sacrifice himself, but you've got a Yule Scepter over on EGM, and you've still got the armor going into that medallion coming over on the Vengeful Spirit, which means you're looking at a very, a Soon Roshan Bulba up in the air. He's considering the Omni Slash. There is no Dire Creep Wave with them. The swap back, G-Rex just gets put in a three-way sandwich, and Pycat with that God Spray, he's got a lot, but Admiral Bulldog, big war stomp, Bulba, he's already used the Omni Slash, and now Alliance, they just turn up the heat, the Mystic Flash trying to force it back, Pycat taking a large amount of damage, EGM also so low, he will finally go down, Koifa with a triple, it's Nikwa with a double, and Loda trying to finish up Koifa, that last little remnant has got enough damage, the jump however is, but it throws away his own life points, Sing Sing was there to get the last attack in, but the dead three-man.
Yeah.
That three-man hook stomp.
If you can replicate that, then sure, Team Tinker could go in here. And we'll look pretty strong. The Dire
has put well, there's your Agassi Maul. They put it into Storm Spirit. He is the most fortified. Puts up the push coming in through bottom. Make sure your Edict's still on cooldown, but just that God Strength now coming out from Pycat. There's your first fortification. Now EGM can let the Edict go. This will not only melt through the tower, but let them burn through that melee rack so quickly. And Team Tinker, they've lost everything. In the time that takes, they come back. It's too much. The Hawk Stomp, it catches out Nikwa. Though you'll set him up in towards the air as Brusselback needs a little alliance right now. Could just again force the issue. How long we got left on that Aegis the Immortal? Can only be like maybe one or two. I'm not gonna take my eyes off this right now. There's your Storm jumping in. Straight back out again. Orb stop, nice done over on two. Ball lightning again being stolen here by G-Rex as Loda. Actually being dragged and Telekinesis out of the Mystic Flare. So Loda's Aegis will trigger here. Have we got another Edict from EGM? Another 8 seconds until it's up. They just want the tower down. But Nikwa is not really wanting to commit this. He doesn't have a lot of life points. Now over Bulldog, jumping in. Like this time over on Pike, and we got the BKB off beforehand. Turned on the God Strength. And goodbye, Senator. Goodbye, Tier 3 Tower. Loader being swapped away. Koipa lets the ulti rip. It does still trigger Loader. So low on life. And there's your ball lining out from Jirak. It'll be yours to set it up. The BS is down. But the Blink Daggers from Alliance will allow them to escape out of here. Pycat, may they go to turn for one more stun. Stormbolt is available. That'll be pretty quick on this one. And he does stop to set him up. And then in for a Warcry, some more bonus as well coming in for Nikwa as he gets Yule set to the Pycat. Mystic Flare, 16's trying to do the solo. Pycat will die up in front of the Roche Pit on Nikwa, TPing out the tree lines. The damage output is enough to get the kill.
How low does Roshan's armor go?
Oh, Medallion, negative 12. Negative 14 went down to at one point. Immortality is mine. And I'm not even seeing the down 600 life points. I'd like to just hit a little chip off with that one. EGM with the Edict. A little bit that's been soaked up by the Moonwell over fortified. On the side, but they do still they use the fortification, which was the goal right now of Alliance. Because that'll open up the rest of the rack. So Loader just keeps beating away at it. They haven't killed it off just yet. Trying to disjoint the orb by doing the jump. Now Omni Slash, Nikwa turns on his BKB. And that's not enough damage coming out from Bulba. Look at that physical damage just ripping through him from the Bristleback. Way too much to deal with. The mid melee rack's now gone. Koipa blinks up over aggressively. Admiral Bulldog also looking for that nice little hoof stomp. The problem is, when everyone's BKB, everyone's immune. The buyback will come out from the SF. They've taken two sets of Raxes now, Alliance. They saw him plant down the Observer Ward, so they can remove that if they have any kind of sentry detection, which they do not, so they say screw it. So Team Tinker will be very, like, they have all the vision they want to on this one. The problem is they have no Omni Slash, there's no Requiem Assault. Jirax just leaping himself in, but the Yule Scepter gonna pick him up in towards the air. He's took a ball lightning, but the Orchid from Loader will control. Now Admiral Bulldog does come in. Again, the BKBs will trigger, and Loader remains on objective base game. While the rest of his team was chasing down Koipa, he's just like, Megas, please, Megas. Get him up and running, and they've got him, in fact. So, Mega Creeps up against Team Rio Tinkerino. And there it is. The GG call comes out from Admiral Bulldog.
I was going to say, the Shadow Fiend having to buy back and crippling his item progression, losing all lanes of racks. There is no way back into this.
Yeah, they would have just been delaying the inevitable. So game number one goes the way of Alliance, looking nice and good in game number one. And game number two will be coming up in just a moment, so do not go anywhere. We've also got more action coming up later tonight as we'll be casting, Pain Gaming going up against Fire. That's Fire with a recent roster change. TC has been removed.